I would say the Steel Series.
Steel Series, honestly.
Steel Series.
I'd definitely sit with the Steel Series.
By far.
Definitely the Steel Series.
If I had to pick one of these to pick up in game right now, it's going to be the Steel Series.
Gamers prefer our headsets. Find out why at SteelSeries.com.
So, welcome everybody to the GO Champions League game between Hellraisers and Copenhagen Wolves. AKA SK. It is still saying Copenhagen Wolves on the GoTV overlay, but I already notified the admins to change it to SK, the Schrodt Commando, as you would pronounce it in English. The German pronunciation is way different. It is Schrodt Commando. And yeah, me being a German helps me. The first time in my life that it helps me. But, well, what is there to say about the two teams? They have definitely had some mixed results. Well, you know, Hellraisers being more or less notoriously known for having mixed results, basically. And the same. And the same goes for SK Gaming, at least if you consider their past matches. They had a really rough time in almost every single league they participated in. So they still need to find their kind of their place right now, and a lot of people blame a certain player to be the kind of weak spot in the squad. But you know, one of the most successful teams in history of CSGO had a very weak play, or considerably arguably a weak player in their lineup. And you know, sometimes they are needed to keep the squad together or just do stuff that the other ones don't want to do, like being the guy to always throw the nades for the good guys, or, you know, in hyphens, the good guys to get the frags. Somebody has to stay behind and flash those guys in, which is no excuse for not getting any frags. So let's see how they will perform today. It is definitely an important match. There is a lower bracket though, so in case any of the teams, well, we will have a loser, but in case, for example, SK loses or Hellraisers lose, we will still see that team once again, at least in the lower bracket, where currently Gamers 2 are waiting after the defeat against Flipside. It was played just yesterday while I was streaming 99 damage. Meters, big shout out to him for standing in for me and helping us out on that. So he casted the game between Gamers 2 and Flipside. It was a 2-0 win in favor of Flipside, and they are waiting for their opponent in the next matchup. And I promised to watch, I promised you to show you the standing, and since I'm on the other overlay right now, I will quickly add that. It's a little bit big, so don't be scared. There it is. So we've got the bracket right here. I know it seems a little improvised, I have to admit, but that is the upper bracket. As you can see, Hellraisers face off against SK. We've got 1337, aka Lead, the X-Property squad, advancing with their, you know, with their league performance. They gained the edge on their first round. The same goes for Na'Vi, but they have the bonus of having two rounds in favor of them. The same goes for Virtus Pro. As you can see, they were topping the league with their 14 wins on Na'Vi and 12 for Virtus Pro. SK Gaming managed to qualify. Penta and Mousebots didn't have zero wins, but they zeroed it down on 99 damage to make it a little bit easier to show. And we had some kind of discussion. Usually, or at first, there were six teams meant to head into the playoffs. We kind of widened that to eight teams because we had some unfortunate turn of events made us do that decision. It was because Hellraisers and actually Gamers 2 as well have been at the very edge of qualification, and then Virtus Pro decided to forfeit a game, which put who was it, Flipside, I guess, on top of them, because they got the default win, and you could argue that Virtus Pro would have probably won the game. So the default win in favor of Virtus Pro didn't change anything on top of the scoreboard, but on the lower part of the playoff spots. So we decided to widen that because the forfeit, you know, it states in the rules that you can forfeit a game. It doesn't, you know, it gives you penalty points, but it, as it was the last match for Virtus Pro anyway, they didn't care about their penalty points. They don't have a chance of getting more penalty points and be disqualified because it was the last group stage game. And then it would have meant that Hellraiser's endgame is too would have been disqualified, or, you know, not being able to participate in the playoffs because Virtus Pro's default loss against Flipside. And yeah, I think the rule change or the kind of change of participants in the playoffs was a good decision by Go Champions League. They handled it as well as they can, or as well as they could, and I believe it was a reasonable decision. I mean, even though the group stage was kind of negated, you know, brought down to zero because we had 10 teams in the group stage and 8 of them qualified, so you eliminate 2 teams by having a very long group stage, which was unfortunate, and we have to apologize to the players for that, but at least we had the chance to watch some awesome games in the... We had quite a few 1-to-1 splits in the league, so actually, if he had... If he had best of threes, we would have seen a lot of triple best of three series. So Hellraisers win the knife round and they stay. Did they win? I didn't follow the knife round. You know, it's kind of weird to cast a knife round, but they start on the CT side. So SK on the uphill struggle already on overpass. Let's see if they can get anything done. The first round would be really helping them. So let's see. We will change the overlay to SK Gaming in a second, so don't worry about that anymore. So we will see SK's pick, overpasses SK picks, so they are expected to perform better than on the second map. Let's see if they can get the first map win and then make Hellraisers feel the pressure. I believe Hellraisers are the favorites in this matchup, but I'm always up for being proven wrong. Doja now goes down to Tenski on the B bomb side. The terrorist actually started off with a widespread setup. Two were in A short, one in A long, and one at B, and the other one in underpass. And now they have gathered in front of the B bomb side while Freeze is still stressing the CTs over at A. The CTs actually come in with the rotation towards the A bomb side. The B bomb side is completely clean for the terrorists to take. Now they are all sweeping in there. The CTs are so out of position, but at least they have the chance to get a group retake going as Sicilian takes down two. Sanding goes down to Kucha. Kucha on the retake. He needs to find more frags. He does get the frag onto Sicilian. Now Adren makes it a 2v2 again, and this is still an open round. The CTs have armor and the terrorists only have one player with armor. So if Kucha and Adren can draw out one of the terrorists, they can focus on the other one, and they both go for different 1v1 battles, and it was the wrong decision to make Hunden and Freeze with the frags. The CTs had to hurry up to defuse the bomb in time, but in my opinion, it's always easier to fight one guy if you have a teammate next to you. And sadly, Kucha and Adren split themselves up and went for the 1v1s. They did get out on the receiving end of that. So SK, aka, you know, the ex-Copenhagen Wolves squad, is leading in this matchup for now. And as you might know, we've got $30,000 up for grabs for the whole tournament. The price distribution is updated already, so you can check out the GoChampionsLeague.gg website. There is also a statistics site that is quite interesting to see, and you can check that with exclamation mark stats in the chat. You will get the link by Moobot. So the terrorists get a nice and easy take on the B bomb set. They put down the bomb uncontestedly. Hellraiser still stays away. It seems like they just want to go for exit frags, and that's not too bad of a decision to make, even though they lose those fights really fast. Freeze and Tenski are the ones to take down the terrorists. Doja, Kucha, and Adren still waiting for the T's to exit, and it looks promising on the exit of the B bomb side. Kucha and Doja are there. Kucha goes down to 8 HP. Now Doja goes down to Tenski as well as Adren, and Kucha is still alive in the back. He's got a P250 but gets eliminated by Hunden with a hatchet of the UMP. At least three players taken out by Hellraisers did do some economical damage to SK and kept their money as low as possible, basically. Obviously, eliminating four players would have been even better, or five and getting the defuse, but Hellraisers didn't really invest in the second round. Now they have Famasas, though, and four of them on everyone except for Doja, who has a Deedle. And it seems like the terrorists are not fooled by that. They have the AWP in the hands of Freeze already. And the CTs with an aggressive setup outside of the A bomb site. Let's see if they can get anything done with that. Mo, Adren, and Kucha are there to help each other out. SK opens up. Asilian, the kind of star player in the squad, gets a headshot onto Mo. He already got a few really good frags in the pistol round. Now Adren with the refrag, but once again, it's Asilian to step it up for his squad. Then it's Kucha to reinforce the position, and he gets a bomb dropped right in front of him. Freeze, though, puts down Doge, and the A bomb site is opened up by the terrorists, but the CTs still have control of the bomb. And Adren, Kucha and Angel are trying to hold on to that. Kucha with a good double kill there onto Freeze, and Asilian leaves Tenski alone on the B bombsite. 45 seconds, that's plenty of time to work with. But the CTs are probably aware where he's coming from, and they pick up everything they can. Angel now with the AK, Famas still on Kucha, and Tenski kind of waves a big flag around where he's coming from with the flash on the A bombsite, but he doesn't waste any time taking out Angel. Now he still has 25 seconds to work with. Kucha trying to hide away in toilets, and Tenski tries to fake him by flashing out into A long, but now he comes stomping down A short. Kucha will be prepared for that, and he lines up that shot as he had the perfect angle. Kucha with the 4K saving Hellraisers in this situation with 3 kills at first, and then closes out the 1v1 situation perfectly for the Ukrainian slash Kazakhian squad. SK with the save round. Now they weren't allowed to get the economy going for them, as Hellraisers eliminated three players in the second round, and the Danish squad is now down to one Tech 9 in the hands of Hassilian, who has the most frags for them, and P250 400. The rest with Glocks and no armor. That's the most important part about that save. Kucha will be facing off against C. Got the first, gets a second. Mo helps out with a shot onto A with his AWP as his Senden gets one. Adren already closes Tenski out then with the Uzi and the P2000. So Hellraisers with the 2-2-2 draw. A really nice scoreline to announce there. And SK with the next buy. So the CTs and the terrorists are both going for not the kind of standard play, which would have meant that the CTs would go for P250s in the second round, maybe armor on top of that, and trying to close out the terrorists straight away. They play it a little bit differently. Hellraiser still has the MP7 for Angel, but still the AWP in the hands of Mo. Kucha goes down in toilets, though. Good opening for the A bombsite for the terrorists. The CTs with the instant rotation. Look at how hasty Hellraisers are rotating towards the A bombsite. Tenski is left with an open B bombsite to take. Only Doja still hanging around on that. So the terrorists, if they figure that out in the long term, you know, you have to look into the future. Maybe it doesn't matter in this round, but it might matter in the upcoming rounds. Adren gets a frag in a toilet. It's another nice headshot onto Senden. He doesn't get the other one, though. Hunden steps it up. 3v3 situation. Freeze is already on the A bombsite, trying to cut off the rotation, and he gets a headshot onto Mo. Angel, however, still hanging out in toilets, gets himself a double kill. 2v1 situation in favor of the CTs, but Angel was out of bullets, and Tenski capitalized on that. 1v1 now. The bomb is on the back of Tenski, who tries to put it down on the A bombsite, and Doja on the rotation coming in from the stairs. Tenski doesn't take too much time with the headshot. He dispatches of him and makes it 3-2 again. SK putting up a real fight, and it is their map pick, so they are supposed to do that. But I didn't expect them to win this round, especially after the first exchanges in a long. It seemed like Hellraisers could have the edge in the 2v1, especially as Tenski gets himself on the board and makes it 3-2 for the Danish squad. Once again, the CTs with the 4 spy. They don't have any armor on Kucha and move with the FAMAS and the AWP. Angel goes down straight away to Senden. Tenski with a good spray of his AK gets to work on Doja, makes it a 3v5, even though Hunden and Sanden are so low on HP, the CTs might actually just go for the save and not try this at all. They have invested so much money in this round, there is no point in risking all their economy right now. They would risk going down to 6-2, maybe even. So good decision by Hellraisers, even though the buy decision to make right now was a little bit weird. They tried to surprise SK, but in turn SK surprised them with two frags. And it's always nice to have a round in the bag with only two frags. You don't have to stress your nerves too much. And look at how defensively SK are exiting the bombsite right now. They are not looking for those kills. They could do that, but their own economy is not looking too strong either, so they rather have their own economy going and have some more additional buy rounds in case they lose one. And that's, you know, maybe a good decision, maybe not. It will show in the upcoming rounds. Hellraisers, though, with a more or less halfway save, they once again have a mixture of weaponry on their squad, and the Cillian just walks into the B bombsite. Good spray with the headshot, close out Adren, another one for a Cillian, closing out Doja. Kucher and Mu are the last man standing. Kensky goes down to Mo, and we've got Freeze capitalizing on him in turn on B short. Kucher is the last man standing, and that's always a hard spot to be in against four terrorists with a planted bomb. There's nothing that he can do about the outcome of the round. You could maybe get a frag or two, but his main priority should be saving his gun right now and the armor, maybe even the flash, because dealing economical damage to the terrorists is not actually worth that much in this situation. There is no way that he can force him to save or force him to have one play with the Tech-9 or P250 or something like that. So Kucher is wise to stay away from the terrorists, even though he pretends to go for exit frags. It's not the most likeliest route to take for the terrorists in this situation. And they go up 5-2 in favor of SK Gaming. Who would have thought? I don't know. Let's check this CSGO launch odds really quick. We've got 21% in favor of SK Gaming, 79% in favor of Hellraisers. With a rough start, though, the Ukrainian mixture team is giving a few teams, a few guys, probably a few viewers as well, some goosebumps and shivers out of scare, out of fear, because it doesn't look too bright right now. But still a lot of rounds to be played in this first half, and remember, comebacks on the terrorist side are always possible to happen. Even though the CTs once again lose the first fight, which is limiting their kind of ability to react to the terrorist movements. Even though Kucher is able to draw back to a 4v4 situation, the CT is still trying to get something working, and they try to get some information. Kucher is inching forward, trying to find any terrorists approaching the A bombsite, and he has spotted Hunden jumping in that situation, in this position, right next to him on the other side of the wall. He lurks forward and he gets spotted just in time. Penske was about to walk into him. Mo with the frag onto Cillian. In the meantime, Hunden with the frag onto Kucher, and Hunden with another one then goes down to Angel. However, it's Freeze in a 2v1 situation. We've seen the CTs lose this situation once, but now Doja is saving it for Hellraisers. Makes it 5-3. The Ukrainians stay alive, but SK still has enough money for another buy round, so Hellraisers need to string a few more rounds together to finally make the terrorists save and get themselves back into this game. If they win this round, they should be able to at least have a forced buy. In the next round, so SK will probably buy in the upcoming round in case they lose this one, and Hellraisers needs to make it 5-5 until they get the terrorists to save. So SK has two rounds to work with until they are down to pills, and that's putting a strain on Hellraisers' nerves and, you know, giving the terrorists a lot of opportunities to make up for any mistakes or reset their strategies. Kucher, though, on fire today with a double kill in toilets. Angel with one as well. Makes it a 2v4, and the terrorists are still on the A bombsite with one player. It is Freeze checking out A long, and he's got Tensky on his on the other side, basically, of A, in the toilets, working his way forward, and the CTs check out the B bombsite. They consider the terrorists to rotate to the B bombsite. Kucha is still in his position, taken down to 40 HP thanks to an aid by Tensky, who predicts his position, and a great headshot by Tensky takes down Kucha. This is still possible for the terrorists to happen if the CTs don't come in with the rotation really quickly. Tensky could get another frag, but he has a bomb in his hands on the right moment, and Doja has his rifle ready to take down Freeze, makes it 4-5, and well, a few quick frags on the A bombsite could have turned this round around in favor of SK. Luckily for Hellraisers, they maintained their position and they had Doja coming in from behind already. So this was perfect play by Hellraisers in this round at least. SK, as I said, still able to buy up. Freeze lacks the weaponry. He only has a P250, but he can pick up a rifle in case a teammate gets taken down, or in case a teammate gets a frag without being traded, he can pick up the weapon of the CT. And he will probably just stick to one of his teammates and... oh well. Actually, he's not sticking to his teammates. He's opening up on a long, while Angel opens up on the terrorists on the B bombsite. Tensky gets taken out. Handen retreats and joins his teammates on the A approach. SK looking for options, looking for openings as the CTs try to close that door on the A bombsite. Adren with a good spray onto Freeze, even though it took him some time. Freeze was jumping around trying to dodge those bullets. Kucha in the meantime takes out a Cillian. 2v5, the CTs seem to have finally got their feet on the ground. And, you know, I already used that cat metaphor. I'm sorry for my microphone cutting out. I will fix that real quick. Give me a second. So back we are. Sorry for that small hiccup. The Terror is finally saving, and Hellraiser should have an easy round to work with, but in turn, SK gets a great opening frags, three of them on the B bombsite. Three Terror is still alive, Hunted with the rifle, even though he's down to 10 HP. He uses it to take down Kucha, the star, kind of this, of those five rounds that Hellraisers have won. He was one of the crucial parts in the lineup to close out those A plays of SK, and now it's Mo standing in the overlook. Handen has him lined up, doesn't hit those shots, goes for the spray through the wall, but doesn't hit any bullets at all. Now he just plays his position, lets his teammates work. Tensky is able to pick up a rifle. Handen actually wanted to drop this rifle before the round was over, and he pressed the button just as it was. So the CTs with that AWP in the hands of Doja, a Hellraiser's thing to do, in my opinion. And let's see if it pays off. Kucha with one frag. Doja is under some fire, and Adren takes all the bullets, takes down Freeze with him. Doja with the frag onto a Cillian, but Sandin with a quick trade. 2v2 situation. Angel picked up an AK, but he doesn't have any armor. And he doesn't have a too good position right now to battle those terrorists. He's in toilets. He's The bomb is still dropped outside of the A bombsite, and Sandin and Tensky need to figure out where Angel is right now. They gave him a lot of time to change his position. Now they are smoking him off and going for the B bombsite. Angel should have read that move. As soon as the terrorists are not coming around that corner in a few seconds, he will rotate to the B bombsite while SK is doing the same. And SK will be faster on that, as Angel is still wasting a lot of time waiting for the terrorists. He doesn't want to be fooled in the situation, and now he knows that it's going to be the B bombsite thanks to another flash popping over at the other side of the map. Bomb gets planted, and Angel has rotate and he goes for that retake against Itensky and Senden. Well, just tries to check out a few angles, doesn't spot them at first, and now saves that AK. Hellraisers go down 7-5 on the CT side of Overpass, which is a CT-sided map. So good performance by SK, surprising at least me and probably a lot of you guys as well. 11 frags for Tensky, 11 for Sandin, the young gun in the lineup. And 15-4 Kucha on Hellraisers, 9-4 Adren. And well, Angel just saved his weapon there. He missed that AWP shot, but at least Sandin wasn't able to take him down in turn. So that scope gets taken to the next round. Hellraisers once again with the 4 spy. MP7 for Doja now. No head armor for Kucha, Mo, and Adren, which doesn't matter too much on the CT side as you get taken out with one headshot of the AK anyway. But still, if one of the terrorists has to switch to the pistol, a head armor could help stay alive. Oh, Hellraisers need to step it up. They need to make it at least 8-7. Otherwise, I can't see them get back into this first map. But it's a best of three, and we will see their own map pick being played after this one, which will be Dust2. And I believe that Hellraisers is stronger on Dust2 than they are on Overpass, but let's see how this first half turns out. Kucha with a frag onto Sending, Kucha with another one. Once again, it's Kucha making it happen for Hellraisers, even though Hanan is able to reply. It's a 2v3 already, and the terrorists are on the verge of taking it to the B. Bombs at Hanan, opens that door. He has spotted the CT by jumping around there on the other side of the wall. He knows that there is at least one CT over at the B bombsite. They probably have information that there are two players left on A, and Freeze with that opening frag on the B bombsite will put down the C4 just in a second. Hunden checks out the rotation and a good shot onto Doja. That was an important frag, otherwise it would have been a really, really hard position to defend himself from for Freeze, as the CTs, consisting of only one player anymore, are pushing in. It is Mo trying to make it happen. He's getting flashed from short already. He knows that Freeze is on one side, Hunden is on the other one. Perfect lineup for the terrorist. He catches an 8 straight to the face, and he's not going to make it in time anymore. He backs off, tries to save his equipment. He's got quite a lot of that on him. Armor and defuse kit and the rifle. Not to forget about that. And SK have the 8th round in the bag already. What a great performance by the Danish squad. Mainly due to a team effort, basically. 11 frags for Tensky and Senden, 10 for Isilien, who is usually the star player for SK, 9 on Hunden, and Freeze only has 6 kills right now, but he didn't have too much work to do with the AWP, and whenever he met somebody, he took him out as well. So sometimes you just don't have the chance to take down more players than you can. Now the CTs with that one safe rifle, they try to put it to use on a long, but Freeze gets that frag onto Mo. Asilian disposes of Adren. The CTs out of position, trying to rotate, and there is still one terrorist in front of the B bombsite, and he's not aware of Kucha getting into the back of his teammates. This could be a crucial play for Kucha. He doesn't fire that shot. He wants to see where the rest of the terrorist squad is. He's just approaching Freeze, now executing him, taking that AWP, wrong turn to make. Hunden with the headshot. If Kucha had stayed with the 5-7 in that situation, it could have been a different exchange. But now Angel and Doja try to find positions to take to defend themselves from the terrorist attack. Asilian and Senden already check out A long. Doja goes for the information. He could either go into A long or check out A short, and Tensky will face off against Doja. Doja now knows that the action will happen over at A long. He doesn't call in for the rotation though. Angel is still staying on B. Now he makes the move towards A, and Doja has to battle it out with 4 angry terrorists coming his way. The Tech 9 of Hunden doesn't do the job yet, but he wants to secure the stairs first, and he's got the AWP to line that shot up. While Senden hoses down Doja from the back, Angel is the last man standing on Hellraisers. Can he do anything about the outcome of the round? It would have been a massive comeback into the round, but it doesn't happen. Senden with the second kill of the round, making it 9-5 in favor of SK on the first map here in the best of 3 series in the Go Champions League, brought to you by G2A, Twitch, and of course SteelSeries. So thanks to our partners for making this happen and putting $30,000 on the line for the teams to fight for. It's a great... Wow, that was a nice boost. It's a great feat to have. Mo takes out Handen due to having him spotted by the sounds of the stairs at first. Now Azalian capitalizes on Mo trying to get away from the position again, but Kuchi is still lurking around and the terrorists are just simply not able to take him down before he gets a frag. He puts down Senden down to 8 HP on top of that and makes it look good for Hellraisers to win the last round of this first half. Adren gets a kill onto Senden, makes it a 2v3. Now the favor is definitely on the CTs, but Freeze fights back. As I said, when he meets somebody, he will take him out as well. So he puts himself up on the scoreboard as well. Angel trying to find the terrorists' backs turned towards him while they are trying to attack the A bomb set. And good peek by Freeze, but he doesn't fight. He doesn't even hit the shot or fire a shot. And Angel with the second following kill makes it 9-6. 3-round lead in favor of SK on the terrorist side. Looking promising for the Danes. So, yeah, I didn't actually notice it, but Copenhagen Wolves finally got exchanged for SK in the overlay. So, we are heading into the pistol round with the right names on the teams, and SK still has that 3-round lead. If they manage to win the pistol round, would be... And you know, CSGO is a mind-based game. It is a momentum-based game as well. And if Hellraisers start off losing this second pistol round, could turn really ugly for them. Especially on the motivation and on, you know, kind of the mindset of trying to get back into this map. As Angel takes out Freeze, who was lurking outside of the B bomb, said he could have gotten a few surprising frags on the terrorist, but he was spotted in time. So now the terrorists will rotate back towards the A bombsite while the CTs get ready for the B execution. Now the CTs will actually rotate back towards A, and the terrorists will not have the positional advantage at all. They are still a little late on A. The CTs already got themselves into the good crossfire setup, and now they will actually re-rotated while Handen takes out Mo. Look at a re-rotation by the CTs, leaving the air bomb site up for grabs for the terrorists. Good job by Mo, just drawing the attention back towards the B bomb site by just showing himself. And SK was a little bit too hasty on the rotation, but it's a pistol round. You have to be quick to make it happen. Angel shoots Azalian straight in the face, but Tensky does the same to Doja. Kucha takes out Handen, and now it's only Tensky on the CT side. He picks off Angel. Good shot on him, but he knows that there's no chance of making it happen against the two terrorists. They would have been amazingly stupid to expose themselves to the USP, and he got he's got the defuse kit, but doesn't have anything else to work with. Kucha still checks out the bomb just to be extra sure that there's no ninja defuse coming in. Tensky picks him off for that, but the round goes in the favor of Hellraisers, so it is 7-9, and the Ukrainians stay alive in this matchup, taking it to a closer scoreline at least. And the CTs with the save, now having that defuse kit on Tensky. They've got the 5-7 on Handen and Tensky, and a P250 for Freeze and the Cillian. The Cillian goes for the armor as well. SK investing small amount of money to try and make the most kind of damage that they can do to the terrorists. Doja, however, takes down Senden and puts a good nade onto the CTs. Handen goes down to Doja's Uzi and another one onto Adren, or for Adren rather. 2v4, the bomb goes down. Tensky and Azalian are around the B bomb site. They are trying to get through the smoke and kind of ambush the terrorists, but it's not going to happen. Adren watches his back, and Azalian goes for the save, saving that armor is quite a lot of money, and the P250 and the smoke is something that he can use in the next round to at least make the terrorists stumble a little bit, while his teammates are probably going for full save. He will have armor and a P250 to work with, so it is a reasonable choice to go for the save, but he more or less has to stay alive in the upcoming one to make a real impact on the rifle round that's coming up in the, well, in the round after this one. Now, Hellraisers with the 8-9 scoreline, one round separating the two teams, so it is actually looking closer than it is, because you have to consider that SK took 9 rounds on the terrorist side. Even though they have a rocky start in the second half, there's nothing to worry about for them. They still have a lot of rounds to work with and expend, and Hellraisers needs to overcome their defense. Cillian checks out A. He spots the terrorist approach. Doesn't call in for the rotation, though. The CTs retreat, and now one player tries to get closer to the A bombsite. It's going to be, let's take a look, it's going to be Sandin on the rotation. Hunden and Tansky join in as well. The terrorists have 5 players committed to the A bombsite. They will check out underpass. Angel just checks the back of his teammates to be sure that there is nobody coming their way from behind. And SK gets ready for that A execution with 4 players. And 5-7 for Sandin, P250 for Hunden and the Cillian. This could be troublesome for the terrorists. They're just poking into the bombsite, trying to find out how many CTs are waiting for them. And Sandin gets a good double kill onto Mo, actually. Makes it a 3v5. Now Kucha and Adren fight back, but Hunden takes down Adren. Makes it a 2v3. The CTs don't have any weapons yet, but Tensky takes out Kucha, picks up that AK. It's Angel alone against the rest of the CTs. This looks like an upset in favor of SK in this third, yeah, in the third round of the second half. Angel just looking for those frags. He's running out of time, though. 18 seconds on the clock. He finds the first headshot onto Hunden. Goes for another spray just to scare the CTs off a little bit. 12 seconds on the clock. He tries to fake the bomb to draw out another one. He catches Tensky on the stairs. Now he's going for the bomb, but he's got 4 seconds to work with. Spots a Cillian, and the Cillian gets the frag. Even though he has the Uzi, he goes for the P250, and that was the right choice. At least he wins the 1v1. Angel, though, with a massive comeback into the round. Almost made it happen for Hellraisers. Shouldn't have been, though. SK win the save round and make it 10-8. Now Hellraisers need to watch out to not get into a downward spiral of, you know, blaming each other or going for 4 spies, having Galils and P250s or Tech-9s or something like that in the lineup. That's something that happens to Hellraiser sometimes. But Angel with a stellar headshot, great reaction, great pre-aim onto Tensky, who tried to go for the information outside of the B bombsite. Didn't happen, though, for the CTs. Well, Tensky got the information that there's one player, but that was all that he spotted. There was a bullet coming his way straight away. 5v4 in favor of the terrorists. The AWP in the hands of Freeze needs to put down a few terrorists to get the CTs back into this round. The Hellraisers are taking it really slow now. They want to be sure to capture the outskirts of the A bombsite without losing too many players, or ideally without losing any players at all. They're going for the peek into the stairs while Angel closes out Sandin on the B bombsite. Now the terrorists will quickly make their way towards that, as Kucha has opened the door already. He knows that there's nobody else. Moog joins in on the rotation as well, as Adren still hangs back on the A bombsite. The terrorists just need to find one more kill on B to open it up completely. Hunden and a Cillian on the boost. And Freeze on the boost. No, actually, it is a Cillian on the boost. I expected the AWP to be boosted up there. A Cillian goes out into the open. Hunden with this instant reply, but the terrorist still on the A bombsite, committed to that. Doja takes out Hunden. Hellraiser swinging back and forth. They are actually unsure where to go until the last few seconds of the round. Now they have finally put down the C4 on A, and Freeze is around in the bank to try and get a few frags, but he won't try to retake, or at least he won't fully commit. He wasted a lot of time waiting for terrorists coming for him. And Razors won't actually go for that frag, I believe. They rather want to have their own economy working instead of trying to remove that AWP. They figure that it's easier to battle against one AWP compared to, you know, having their own economy on the line in the next round and maybe losing a few more rifles. and then being forced to save in, you know, in the matter of one loss or something like that. So Hellraisers save their rifles and it will head into the 9-10 scoreline into the 20th round, trying to draw this game at 10 each, trying to make their own terrorists. Well, my microphone really has a bad day today. Sorry for that, I will fix it in a few seconds. Freeze, though, on the peak, didn't spot anything. He is a guy to watch right now. He is on the rotation as Sandin picks off Angel. Doja takes out Tensky on the B-bombs, and the terrorists are still not committed to anything. They are spread out throughout the whole map. They've got Kucha on Ace, joined by the bomb carrier, which is Mu, and Adren and Doja just hanging out in the underpass right now, rotating towards their teammates. Adren will hold on to the rotation, just keep the CTs inside the B bombsite, and SK with a good guess, with a good informational play, they rotate to the A bombsite, maybe a little bit too early, because now Hellraisers actually know that there is CT action around, so they might be scared away just by noticing the CTs. Let's see. Freeze is around the A bombsite in the back, so he's guarded by two kind of meat shields that will draw the attention away. But like I said, Hellraisers will gather the information, and there are too many CTs on A, and they will rotate back to B, where Hunden is alone with his P2000. He still picks up one frag onto Doja, which he shouldn't have done. But Kucek closes out a Cillian on the A bombsite. He knows that there's one more CT that he has to fight before he can join his teammates, and he catches Sendin with a good angle. 2v1 situation though, thanks to Freeze refrag on B, and the bomb is planted. Freeze is going for the retake already, while Adren trying to circle around the pillar. He doesn't get the frag. Freeze doesn't get the frag. Adren will put him to rest and make it 10-10. Still a great round by SK, especially by Hunden, picking up a frag against armored targets with a P2000 in that situation. That was the least that you could have expected by him, and he made it costly for the terrorists together with Freeze. SK with the more or less 4 spy. They only have a few nades on 4 players. Azilian is stripped naked. And 3 FAMASes in their lineup as well. So Hellraisers with a good chance to force the SK squad on a save. But Tensky finds Angel. He exposes shoulder. And Tensky saw Angel before Angel saw him. Mu, though, was able to take down Freeze and pull the trigger before he did. 4v4 situation evolving. Hellraisers on the verge of taking the A bombsite, but they are still slow walking around, trying to get another frag to make this a 4v3 in favor of themselves. Mo covers Adren nicely. Good bait by Hellraisers. Adren was actually jumping around there, drawing the CT's attention towards him, and Mo was covering him. Good trust by the teammates as well. You know, you have to trust your AWP player to make that shot when it matters. Otherwise, Adren would have been taken out and Mo would have looked really stupid in that situation. Hellraisers now with the one-man advantage, and in this case, only have 2 FAMASes on the bombsite A, which is going to be the point of entry for the terrorists. Hunden kind of messes up that Molotov cocktail on top of the car, and Tensky goes down to Kucha. 4v2 now. Hunden and Sendin will save their guns and allow Hellraisers to take the lead in the first map here in the best of 3. In the upper bracket of the Go Champions League. And well, as I said before, it's not too much to worry about yet for SK. As long as they stay afloat and trade a few rounds back and forth and keep hold on their weapons, they could get some more rounds on the CT side. Doja now takes out Sendin, which removes one of the weapons, one of the dangerous guns in the hands, and another one follows up straight away. Good play by Hellraisers to remove all the guns in the hands of SK and force them on a complete save. And that will make this round a lot easier for the Ukrainian squad. Let's check out the scoreboard. Let's see, 18 frags for Sendin, 16 for Tensky, 15 for Hunden, and 9 for Freeze only. So despite the fact that he didn't see too much action on the CT side, he really needs to step it up right now for his squad. 25 on Kucha though, and 15 on Adren and Angel. So Kucha, really stellar performance, especially on the CT side with those A bombsite defenses. If he wasn't around in the first half, I think Hellraisers would have losses even more decisively now. Angel with the spray onto Doja, actually showing his nerves off a little bit. He should have known that Doja was coming from the right. It's highly unlikely that a CT would cross around from that angle. But Angel gets a kill onto Sen, and now it's a 4v5. And the CTs are widespread on the map. Handen picks off at Ren. Really good pistol skills by Handen, I have to say that. But he gets closed out by Kucher once again. The guy to save the day for Hellraisers takes that weapon out of the hands of the CTs and makes the next rebuy for the CTs a lot harder. As Cillian takes out Doja, he's not able to pick up the weapon yet. And the terrorists will try to deny that. Tensky still picks up Angel. Good frag. Really cheeky by him to show up in the last second. And the Cillian was able to pick up the AK just before the round ended. So in the end, it was kind of a successful save round for the CTs. Even though they didn't get the round on the board, at least they got a few frags and a rifle taken into the next round. Hellraisers now with the 2-round lead and a full buy that they need to face off against on SK. And compared to SK, who really favored the A bombsite a lot, Hellraisers are really going for those default strategies. And first, you just check out all the different approaches to both bombsites, with two players working on B, three on the A bombsite, just defensively walking forward, checking if there is anything coming their direction. And they have a different setup, and it seems to be even more successful compared to SK's setup, which was already a 9-6 halftime score on the terrorist side. Now Hellraisers with 6 rounds to the 1 of SK, so it is 6-1. Only 4 more rounds for Hellraisers to close this first map out and make this, and in the end, a good start into this best of 3 series. Now SK with 3 players over at the B bombsite. It is the right thing to do right now. As you can see, Hellraiser is getting ready for the B execution. They have 4 players lined up for that. And Ren is the first to take point. He takes down Sandin. Now Handen comes in with a good spray. Takes down at Ren, and Mo makes it happen for the CTs. But Tensky and Doja trade frags back and forth. The Cillian will finally pick up one. And Tensky got the frag before, and Freeze just closed out. Kucher was trying to get in from behind SK thanks to those quick trades, and thanks to Hunden's double kill on the B entrance, they can stay alive in this game and get another shot at coming back. I mean, they weren't meant to come back into this game at first because they had the lead. Then Hellraisers took over, and now it's a Danish squad to try and get back into the driving seat. They still have to fight off one more by round and possibly a 4-5, depending on the bomb plant situation on Hellraisers. And they really like to 4-5, so I wouldn't count that out. Oh, Angel though, with a lucky turnaround, takes out Tensky and Senden on the front of the B bombsite. They were pushing out to get the information, but they didn't check that corner where Angel was just sitting, basically. Turn around at the right moment. Handen is there to close out the terrorists and slow them down on the B push. And look at Freeze. Look at Cillian being inside the underpass, waiting for Kucher to rotate. And there is the frag. Doja with the instant reply. Now the terrorists back on the A bomb site. So they just re-rotate back and forth, back and forth. Wherever they get the frags, they will turn their heads too. And Freeze picks off Doja, makes it a 2v2 again, and slows down Mu, who was about to enter the bomb site. Now Mu has to win that battle, and he just catches a glimpse of Freeze through the truck, basically, through the exhaust of the truck. Handen is now alone on the stairs, and the terrorists will once again rotate back towards B, where Adren puts down the Su-4 right now. Handen on the rotation already. Adren gets away with his life, and Handen is not able to get to the bombsite in time, so he will save that AWP for his teammate and just back off, let the round go in the favor of the terrorists, and let Hellraisers take the 13-11 lead. So the Ukrainian squad is able to maintain that 1-round lead on SK, but SK still shown off some decent skills, and I believe, you know, one frag on the other side could have turned this round around. Obviously, it was a 2v2 situation, so if Freeze had picked up Mo, would have been a 2v1. Freeze would have had the information on the A bomb site. Hanan would have been able to support him, and I believe that SK would have had a chance to take this round if Freeze had hit that shot. Now they are struggling with their money. Tenski only has a 5-7, 2 Famasters on Hunden and Sandin. And Hellraisers with the full buy and the full commitment to the B bombsite. They're getting in there really quickly. The CTs catch one on the outskirts. Doja, though, picks off Sandin. Now the terrorists need to worry about B short and B bombsite in general. So they are slowing down quite a lot just to see where the CTs are coming from. That allows the CTs to get one player in their back while Hunden takes out Doja. Mo takes out a Cillian with the Tech 9, actually keeps the terrorists in this round. If a Cillian had picked up one or two frags, would have been a 1v4 already. So really important frag by Mo to pick up with that Tech 9, drawing it back to equal players on both squads. But none of the teams know where the other players are at. Tenski is kind of the forefront of the defense for the CTs right now, trying to spot the terrorists by listening to their footsteps, but they're not making a single noise right now. And now he will commit to that backstab and try to find the terrorists. He gave them enough time to, you know, to just get away from him, basically, and not be aware of his presence anymore. So he will sneak forward into A short. Wrong guess to make for him right now, but he will at least catch them on the A bombsite from an unexpected angle. And as soon as he will be able to make that backstab count, but that frag on the B bombsite will draw the CTs to the B bombsite. And actually, Hellraisers didn't plant the bomb on A. They wasted too much time checking every single corner and they failed to plant it. What a huge mess up by Hellraisers. They had an open A bombsite, basically. They were looking for Tenski, but you know, he was not around. He was in their back, actually, and Hellraisers didn't find that in time. They didn't put down the bomb. You know, I mean, why didn't they just go for the plan? They should have done that. Maybe they didn't watch the clock, something that they should be aware. Out of all teams, Hellraisers are probably in the top two, at least, together with Na'Vi. Maybe Mousebots being in the top five or something like that, but they are definitely in the top of the teams that lose rounds because the time runs out on them. Angel and Sandin trade blows on the B bombsite, making it a 4v4 again. Once again, the CTs having one player in the back of the terrorists. It's a Cillian this time. He will try to find any information that is worth forwarding to his CT members. And he will forward that there's nobody on the outside of the B bombsite, which allows Tenski to get in with their early rotation towards the A bombsite and try to help Freeze out, who is still in the back of the bank. Now, Cillian needs to hurry up to make some impact on this round. Freeze missing that shot. Oh, thankfully, Tenski is there to take down Doja, but Adren and Kucha will mop up two frags, and Adren with a very patient kill onto Cillian, just single shooting him, finding that headshot. Sandin on the verge of retaking already. He catches Adren, makes it a double kill, but Mu capitalizes on the fuss, on the chaos that Sandin didn't know where Mu was actually at. And SK loses round. Hellraisers with a 14-12 score, and now the CTs need to save. So was their last chance to make a stint in this game. I believe Hellraisers will at least make it, or should make it, 15-12. You never know in those matchups. SK could just randomly have somebody step up his game, maybe even Hunden, as he already proved his worth with the pistols. Now let's see, Hellraisers on a slow build-up on the B bombsite. Doja loses that battle against the pistol of Cillian. The Deagle didn't hit enough shots. Cillian gets away with it and picks up the Molotov cocktail as well. With 26 HP, he's lucky to get away against the spray of Adren. The CTs still have 5 players to work with. They have Freeze on the A bombsite to spot the terrorists if they should get to the A bombsite, and he spots them in time to call in for the rotation. He's got 2 players to work with. Now Hunden tries to get as close as possible to support his teammate, and Freeze with the P250 fails to take down Angel, Angel able to draw it back to equal players. Kucha with a nice headshot onto Hunden, expected somebody to just hang out on the outskirts of the A bomb set, and obviously they need to check their corners, something that, for example, SK didn't do on the outside of B when Angel was able to pick up an easy double kill. Now Tensky fights back on A, gets shut down by Adren straight away though, sending the last man standing for SK. But the P250 against Moose Tech 9 will not happen for the CTs. Hellraisers have 3 match points. SK need to step it up to defend. SK need to step it up to defend themselves from the 3 match points that Hellraisers now have. And at least they have some weaponry to work with for. At least they have some weaponry for the first try, and the Cillian with the headshot onto Adren. Tensky with one on the B bomb side. Kucha on A though, opening up just like he did on the CT side. It is his territory, basically. Don't dare to trespass on his territory, as he will shut you down. And he briefly got stuck on the balloon there and got out of that. Now checking out the toilets together with Mu, who has the AWP to work with. Mu going for the long range covering, and Kucha just tries to spot any CTs approaching his position. Good spray there, long range spray, hard to control on the AK, but he makes it happen on Hunden. 2v3 now. Tensky and Sandin already wounded, down to 17 HP. Is Sandin on the B bomb side though? He needs to get out on top of Kucha, and he will take down the player that tried to open up on B short. Now the bomb needs to take the long route, which allows the CTs to get even more information and even a better position on B. While Doja checks out the CT's rotation from CT spawn, he doesn't spot anyone. So Tensky and company, well, his only company is Sen right now. They will come in from short and the terrace entrance to B bomb set, basically. So we will have a switch setup. Sen and takes down Moon. Now Doja is out of position. He needs to watch out. He has that angle to cover the bomb from above, but all the smoke will make it really hard to spot the CT's approach. He takes on Sen and then goes down to Tensky, who saves the day for the CT's with the defuse already. Double kill for Tensky, double kill for Sen, and the bomb will tick loud and louder, but Tensky should be able to defuse it just in time, and he gets it done for SK to stay alive and fight another day. Even picks up the AWP to save it for Freeze. And the Danes need to overcome one more buy round of Hellraisers, and then the Ukrainian squad would be left with a forced buy, obviously, in the last round of this first map, which would make it possible for SK to draw it. Let's see if they can get themselves a first frag, which would make the task so much easier. They are leaving Freeze alone on A long, and he will be pushed, but regains sight just in time to spot Mo and take him down straight away. SK tries to find some more information. Hunting going for that spray through the wall, trying just to see something, or, you know, just to hit something. And they will boost up Tensky. Let's see what he's... Oh, well, they just took down that boost again, as Hunden wants to rotate back towards the A bomb site. See if this is the right guess. Hellraisers are notorious for changing the bomb site in mid round. They did it so many times already, and now the chances of that to happen are even more likely, as Freeze takes out Kucha on A. Hellraisers are still committed to A, and maybe the CTs will go for the rotation towards B just to be extra sure, but actually 3 CTs stay at A. Hunden still covering his teammate Asilin is in the corner. He's dependent on Hunden's crossfire. Tensky actually rotates back to B while the terrorists open up on A, with the kill onto the ceiling. Freeze fights back, and finally Freeze has found his form with a triple kill. He disposes of all the terrorists that tried to get into the A bomb site. SK with a 14-15, staying alive in this matchup in the upper bracket of the GO Champions League, brought to you by SteelSeries, G2A, and of course Twitch. So thanks for making it happen. The host of this tournament is Dreams Media, and you can check out the website for statistics and all that. Just go to GOAT Champions League aka GOCL.GG, like it says in the overlay right next to the witch. Right next to Witcher 3. Hellraiser's now with the last effort. They have four Tech Nines. They get the first frag, but now it's SK show all the way. Sandin with a good shot. Triple kill for him. Staying inside the B. Bombsage just fending off all the terrorists. Kucha is alone and he will go down to three. So we will have an overtime. And it's basically the third map that I will... Well, I casted a best of three between Mouse and Neophyte, which ended up having two overtimes on two maps, and they ended up having a winner on the third map only. So SK actually makes me cast the third overtime in four maps, so they will take it to an additional few rounds. I don't know if it's MR5. Yeah, it is MR5 with 16k start money. So get ready for some thrilling match here. Hellraisers and SK trading blows back and forth. 9-6 on both terrorist sides. Amazing to see that. But Hellraisers wasted three chances to close out this game. And they actually failed to do that in the end with the Tech Nines. Sometimes people randomly do stuff that is really amazing with the Tech Nines, especially on those really clutch situations. But Hellraisers weren't able to take down SK in this one, so the Danes will fight another day against the Ukrainians. Mo and Angel now, both with an AWP. Let's check out. Angel is on the B bombsite. Mo is on A long. And Angel will inch forward. He might catch one CT. There, you can see his head. And actually, he's not going to jump one more time. Tinsky stays away. He caught a bullet once already. Now Mu, just to be extra sure, checked out that corner. Heads up play by him to stay safe from the ambush play that the CTs could come up with in that sort of position. Hellraisers with the full commitment to the A bombsite. They leave Angel over at B with his AWP as Cecilian sprays down Kucha. Adren with the frag onto Cecilian. It's a 4v4 again, and Hellraisers are slowing down. 30 seconds on the clock. They either need to commit to A or make a really fast rotation towards B. SK now have only one player at B. They committed to A as Hellraisers are rotating back. SK catches that. Now they caught up with the information, and Freeze is going to step it up for them. Penske with one frag as well. Freeze from the rotation area picks off another one, and their time will run out no matter what Hellraisers try to do. Mu is trying to run away, and once again they fail to make it in time as Mu delayed that exit from the sewers because he wanted that smoke to be fully popped, but he was sprayed down from behind. SK with the first round in his overtime. MR5 is most likely to find a winner in the first overtime. So let's see if SK can pull through with the first round on the CT side. They are in the prone position to take it home. And we've got 32 frags on Kucha, who was... There was a time in CSGO when everybody said, you know, minus Kucha, blah, blah, blah. Now he shows his critics that he is actually able to step it up and have massive performances. And he was doing that for quite some time already. Adren now with a double kill, making it a 3v2 in favor of the terrorists from down below. They fight their way back up on top of the CTs. Tenski and Sandin working separately from each other. And Sandin takes out Angel on the B bombsite. Kucha and Adren need to figure out where those CTs are. They know that there's one on B. The other one is most likely on A, because you would split up in a 2v2 situation just to have eyes and ears on any bombsite to be able to call out for your teammate, delay the push, you know, take down one of the entering players and all that. And Adren is just inching forward towards B, facing off against Sandin in a second, who is just in pit right now, getting back out, looking for the kill. Kucha will try to distract the CETs, and he successfully distracted them. Adren now knows where Sandin is, and he will wait for Sandin to be in position. Good job by Adren. Now he takes down, well, yeah, he puts down the bomb, and I was about to say he will take that nade to throw into the CT spawn area, And he fails that nade completely. Tenski with a good spray now drops into the flames, pulls out his 5-7, pushes Adren. Adren still dancing around. Tenski not able to finish him off with the 5-7. He depletes all his ammunition. Adren just dancing. Both players will go. No, actually, it's only Adren going for the reload. Tenski reloaded his 5-7, and finally he takes down Adren. But the bomb is ticking really fast already. Will he make it in time? I highly doubt that to happen. But he will just take. Oh my god, he just makes the defuse happen when the bomb clicks. That was way too close for Tenski. He wasted so many bullets taking out Adren. Great play by Adren. And one more inch of a second, you know, 1 millisecond more, and the bomb would have exploded. It was ticking already, going white, and you know that the time is over when that happens. Now, Hellraisers need to stay in the game. They need to keep the composure. And their mindset needs to be really good right now. Going down 17 to 15 in the overtime. They didn't expect that, especially as this last round was really, really close. Now, Sandin and Freeze combined with one frag each to make it a 4v3 in favor of the CTs. They have split up two players on A, two players at B. And Hellraisers fully committed to the A bomb site, where Hunden is holding together with Freeze. See, good incendiary nade almost takes Mu down. He's down to 36. He didn't spot the CTs, but he got himself in a very good position. Hunden goes down straight away. Adren tosses that Molotov cocktail into the right position to draw out the other CT. It is Freeze to try and retreat. 19 HP remaining for him. All the players are wounded on the terrace except for Adren, who's still on 100 HP. Mu burns alive, courtesy of Tenski, who takes down Adren as well. Doja is the man to watch for the terrace right now. The CT is on the rotation. They have all the players around, and Freeze will dispose of him. Make it 18 to 15 in favor of SK Gaming. Seems like they got themselves together in the kind of post regular playing time pause, and they figured out how to play the CT side right now. Hellraisers with their last chance to get a full buy going. If they fail to plant the bomb, they need to scrape their pockets and have a forced buy with 4.4k on Kuchin, 4.6 plus the loser bonus. They could actually have a halfway decent buy on at least three players, but it's going to be amazingly hard to win a round like that. Azillion using the stairs to look over the smoke and takes out Doja with that. Really good 4v5 now in favor of CTs, and they didn't spot, well, they have spotted Angel, I believe. He's in his favorite position. He took down two CTs from that. They failed to check that corner when they were trying to push for information. Azillion now in the underpass, looking for more kills. He picks off Adren, then has to 180 degree turn to take down Kucha, but he's not able to do that. Kucha will kill him straight away, makes it a 3v4. Getting back into the round, that Angel goes down to Sandin now. The CTs restore the player advantage, and Adren almost, Angel almost got another frag with that mad spray. He turned 90 degrees just to have that spray still going, you know, and control that. It's sometimes easier compared to resetting your aim. Kucha will get a double kill here in the A bombsite. He gets out on top of Hunden as well. Sandin is now coming in from behind. Hunden, Kucha needs to stay aware of that, and he does turn around way too slow. Sandin with an easy frag there, and a 1v1 goes in favor of SK once again. A 1v1 situation ending in favor of the Danish squad. Now they are sitting at 19 to 15, almost a flawless CT half in the first half of this first overtime already. And look at that team effort by SK Gaming. 30 frags on Tenski, 29 on Sandin, 23 and 24 the rest. And we've got 36 on Kucha, 23 on Adren, 22 on Angel, and only 16 and 14 frags in more than 30 rounds by Doja and Mo. They need to show up in this matchup if Hellraisers wants to have anything to say in this upper bracket match of the GOAT Champions League. HR Unknown lining up the B-bomb, so they get the first few frags. Angel with a double kill actually, taking out Tenski and Senden. Hunden with the nade. With a nade, answers onto Angel, but it's a 4v2 courtesy of Mo, who took down one more CT. Now Adren catches Acilian on the backstab, basically. Free is the last man standing. He doesn't need to save. It's the last round of this first half, but Kucha has one bullet with the name of Freeze on it. And Hellraisers at least win one terrorist side, one terrorist round on this first overtime. So, not too good of a performance, but considering that they had two 1v1 situations that were really close, especially the one that Adren was not able to win, I believe that this could have gone the other way around as well and could have ended 18-17 in favor of Hellraisers. So let's see if they can gather themselves and get ready for the second half, as SK only need to win two rounds on the terrorist side to win this first map. We would head over towards 2-2 as soon as this map is over. It is the second map and it is the pick of Hellraisers. So SK having trouble on their own map pick, but they are the more or less underdogs, so you would expect them to have some struggle ahead of them. They did fairly well though, and they actually showed off that they are not a shame to be picked up by SK, as some people on some forums suggested. Now Hellraisers going for only one AWP compared to their double AWP setup. Oh, my microphone, sorry. Compared to the double AWP setup that they went with in the terrorists overtime, they now have four rifles, and SK with the A lineup, they are getting ready for the execution. Freeze pulls the trigger on Mu, even though Mu pulled the trigger first. I don't know what made him miss that shot, but maybe he was, you know, not on the target yet, but his eyes already triggered the reaction. And SK with the man advantage, looking good in this opening round of the second half of the overtime. Kucha though, it's his territory. As I said, the A bombsite is his place to be. He takes down two players, but Sanden and Hunden fight back and make it a 2v1 in favor of the terrorists. Angel though coming in from behind, taking out the bomb carrier, and Acilian is in a hard spot. Angel knows where the bomb is, but Acilian does know where Angel is at the same time, and now Acilian will just try to rush to the B bombsite. It is rather fast for him to rotate, so he should make it in time. And Angel still waiting on the outskirts of the A bombsite to have the positional advantage in case Acilian went for the A bombsite. And now the bomb is planted. Angel knows where it's going to be, and he, well, Acilian should have heard those few shots being fired off, but he doesn't adjust his position or his pre-aim. So Angel just stomping around on the B-bombsite, trying to draw Acilian out of his cover. He's running out of time, and there is Acilian with the patience of an old-school player, of an experienced one. He takes it to match point for SK in the first map here against Hellraisers in the GOAT Champions League upper bracket. And I will show you that bracket when the map is over, so you can get a small overview of that. SK now having four match points against the Ukrainian / Kazakhian squad, with Adren and Mu being from Kazakhstan, of course, if you haven't known yet. So the Danish squad with once again the opening frag onto Angel. Good shot by Tenski, good position, but then he exposes himself to Doja spray and allows the CTs to get some hope back on their minds, back into this round. As Hellraisers went for the three-man stack on the A bombsite right now, they have Kucha, Mo, and Adren over there. Doja is checking out the B outskirts, and he knows that there is nobody around, so the CTs are right to have three players over there, while the terrorists are splitting themselves up, two on A long, two on A short. Let's see if they can get those opening frags. Kucha is there to help his teammates out from behind with a flash. And Adren is actually getting closer and closer to the terrace. He will be the key player for the CTs to make something happen. He hears all the steps. He calls in for the rotation. Even though Doja will be late, Sanen takes out one, takes out the second as well. Doja and Adren, the last man standing for Hellraisers to keep them in this map. Adren with the frag from behind, but now the terrace, no way he's coming from, and they have one player committed to that. Freeze is just backing off into a long, trying to get another angle onto Adren, and he will successfully get that. Really good heads up play by SK, sending Freeze back there. Ascendant takes out Doja, and Freeze will dispose of Adren. So SK winning the first map, upsetting Hellraisers, making it 21-16 on Overpass, and we have a lead fragger on SK of 33 frags for Send and 31 for Tenski. And my game breaks down at a most fitting moment in time. So thank you for tuning in, guys. We will be back with the second map of this thrilling matchup. I didn't believe, or I didn't think, that SK would be able to get back into this game or to win the first map at all. So they had the first kind of 9-6 lead. Then they went down 12-10. And then they managed to take over and make it in overtime. Then managed to win this overtime almost flawlessly. So congratulations to the Danes for the first map. We will be back with the second, Dust 2, the map pick of Hellraisers, coming up in a few moments. So stay tuned, guys. I'm Dabu from Germany, and you're watching the GOAT Champions League upper bracket matchup between Hellraisers and SK. I almost called them Copenhagen Wolves.